Hello, fellow makers. Welcome to another Wolverine video. I decided to create a new one because last one is without description. With that out of the way, let's get to it. To make it slightly different, I decided to use head from a different model. So when you decide to get this one, don't be surprised, even though you might not notice at all. Let's start with the head. Firstly, I primed the face with white primer. Then I used Tamiya spray cans to create base tone with tan and then wooden deck tan on it. To make skin a little bit darker, I gave it a spray with this Createx paint. Next, I created red shading. Before that, I lowered the pressure on my airbrush to very low to sprinkle large dots on the skin. Then I put the pressure back to normal. For the shading itself, target all the crevices, under the lips, under the nose and on the cheeks. I'll do the same with the brown color. Lastly, I create some darker spots with smoke. It is very easy to overdo, so you have to build up some sort of right feeling for this technique. Now I make some highlights with lighter color and then smoke to create 5 o'clock shadow. Then once again lower the pressure on airbrush and sprinkle larger black dots. Clean up large blobs with clean brush and thinner if needed. If you watch my other work, you know by now that we never paint eyes and teeth with pure white. Also, to create better contrast between each tooth, I use Citadel wash and transparent gray. Before I paint with yellow, I first use white primer and then pink color. With this little trick, you will achieve nice and rich yellow shade. I did whole body like that. On the hands, I use basically the same method as on the face. So just repeat those steps. Also, it's worth to mention that I am periodically sealing my progress with matte varnish of the camera. When you do shading with red pastels, sometimes it's not easy to figure how much to use. Some of them gets blown away during sealing and some of them gets killed by varnish. So don't be afraid to repeat the process. Here I used the razor saw to create some additional battle damage. I also used Dremel tool to create bullet holes. and as usually, I use glossy black as a primer for metallic paints. Shoe polish is a great way how to create dirt on your model. Unlike acrylic wash, you can easily clean it off with a wet sponge after it dries, leaving awesome effect. Thank you. Okay guys, hopefully you like this updated version of Wolverine and maybe learned something new. If you enjoyed the video, please leave a like and consider to subscribe if you like to see more. Thank you for watching and keep on making.